Well, hello, my friends. Welcome to another episode of FAQ Sergio. Today, I'm here sitting with my good friend, Nadine Robbins. We're going to talk about TikTok. Maybe you have heard about TikTok before. I'm sure you have. So let's talk about why artists, you know, should consider looking at TikTok seriously. Well, Nadine, good morning. How are you today?
I'm doing good. How about yourself?
I am doing great, Midwest meets East Coast right now. Super happy to be here with you. And today we're going to talk about TikTok because that's a platform that's been in the news lately quite a bit. And I think people have been hearing more and more about it. Artists are curious about it too. And so I wanted to start kind of a series of episodes in which we look at TikTok as well. And you're an artist who have been working on TikTok. You've been using TikTok. And I like what you're doing in the platform too, which is great. I know you from, I think we have known each other for quite a bit of years. I don't know how many, but many years.
At least 6 or 7 years for sure.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Something like that. We always usually commenting on each other, things that we're doing as well, respectively. And so it's always been fun working with you. And today we decided, why don't we talk a little bit about TikTok and the experience that you had there. So how long have you been on TikTok and how did you get interested on it the first time?
Well, it's funny, about a year and a half, maybe 2 years ago, I had first downloaded it.
Okay.
And wanted to play around with it, but I heard that there was a real security breach, so I ignored it.
Okay.
Until I started to see that there was more activity, and I was like, let me go explore and see what it's about. And that was probably in April, during COVID, because I was like, okay, well, I mean, honestly, I wanted to be able to do something where I can make a little money on the side, which helps, pay for art supplies and all that. And that's how that began.
Yeah.
And so since then, I've been playing around with it and learning what it does and, dispelling the myths that a lot of people have about TikTok. And, I've been part of this mastermind group, which had real in-depth education and knowledge about everything from politics that have been happening, about TikTok and all these different sort of techniques and hacks that you can do to get lots of followers and views. So that's kind of how I got into it and why.
No, that is great. And you talk about some of the myths, and I think in a future episode, we should go back and talk about those more in depth. But one of the biggest ones that I've heard is that, well, TikTok is just for kids. So tell me a little bit about, I'm sure you have heard that many times too, So tell me more about it.
Well, it initially was a dance app and it was for kids. And that's why you see so much, dancing on it. And that's fun and everything, but it has eventually it is for kids, but those kids are getting older.
They're not staying as kids.
that's the big thing. And TikTok is in its infancy right now as these people are getting older. And so the last I heard that the demographic was, I think it was 12 to 15 or something like that. Mm-hmm. And then within 6 or 7 months, it was becoming more like 17 to 23. Mm-hmm. And so you can already see that you can follow your followers depending. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of cool.
And it's very, very fast. Yeah. I mean, when you consider that Facebook, when it started, it was for college students. Now it's for the grandmas and grandpas who wants to see whether, what the kids are doing.
Exactly.
The grandkids, right?
Yeah.
That's how my parents look at what I'm doing. So, then same for Instagram. Instagram started, it's just for the teenagers. You take selfies and pictures. Now we are all there, right? And now there's just TikTok. So things evolve really fast. And I think that evolved faster than ever before because of the previous history of other platforms. And it's evolving. And I think as artists, and it's something that you and I, we have talked about, as people age and as we're looking as artists also to grow our base and our collector base, we also want to bring into our, to our audience, the younger audience, because they, when they may become collectors as well.
Sure. Absolutely.
Yeah.
They have a lot more disposable income. I mean, I've found that, some of the followers that I have, if they want to print, they're happy to drop, you know, $50, $70. I know that's not a lot for a print, but they're younger, right?
Exactly.
But they have that type of disposable income.
And that's how they start.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. They want prints, they want something drawn for themselves. And, you know, that's a little tricky. You know, you don't want to become the person that draws everybody on Facebook. But
right.
Conversation.
So, I mean, Larry Gagosian, he started selling posters. You know?
Exactly. You start somewhere, right?
So, mm-hmm. Exactly. Mm-hmm. You know, that's how it all starts for somebody who may grow that passion, and that's what they can afford now, but then they'll evolve and mature. So tell me about, you know, when you look at, you know, TikTok versus Instagram, right? Which kind of was like the jump for most people right now we're speaking about artists, right? We are already on Instagram trying to grow, and it's so hard right now on Instagram because it's been around for a long time. So a lot of the audience is big. There's a lot of content also. Algorithms are getting worse and worse in terms of organic reach and so on. But tell me, how do you compare that experience to now, let's say, jumping into TikTok?
Well, that's the, you know, that's the beauty of TikTok is that it is organic growth. Mm-hmm. It's where Instagram used to be.
Right.
So you can be rewarded with views and everything just as much as, you know, Apple. Mm-hmm. It you know, good content is going to get you followers and views. That's it. But the difference, what I liked about going from Instagram to TikTok is that it's much more dynamic. You know, it's all video and nothing flat. So I just don't feel like flat is going to really work anymore. So that's the beauty of fine art and TikTok, mm-hmm. is we can show the art, mm-hmm. but how do you make that art become, you know, interactive or... I don't know what I'm trying to say, but I think I made my point.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, I mean, and there's something about us when we look at a device and something is moving, there's motion. And within that motion, what I love about TikTok is when I look and there's like storytelling, you know, also exactly. with those 15 seconds or 30 seconds or 60 seconds, you know, which is the maximum of the TikTok video. But, you know, even the short ones, sometimes this storytelling, we were talking about like the reveals, like wait for it, or it's coming, or something's about to happen and you're waiting for it. And there's been like, and there's some of them, like, and you're waiting and never nothing happens. And you're like, and it makes you come back for more. Right. Mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. There's also that kind of seed of, that puts in your brain of intrigueness of you want to look at more and more.
Yeah.
I mean, those platforms are made for that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, Instagram is still really valid. And, you know, I'm not saying that we don't want to, you shouldn't right. use that. I just think that, you know, and this Reels, which is now a direct competitor of TikTok, but very limited in what it can do and compare, you know, TikTok is much more robust.
Right.
But that's, you know, I think the beauty of having both, and also, I will give you an important tip is that TikTok encourages sharing on all other platforms.
Mm.
So having a lot of your followers on TikTok, they expect to share wherever people, and people don't have to have the app necessarily to see those videos.
All right. So you can make a TikTok and share it to your Facebook. You can share it to your Instagram.
Absolutely. They can see it, or, you know, I'll text it to people, you know, video that I like, and they can click and open it up, but yet they don't even have an account.
That is great.
So, you know, you don't have to have, so it's, I like the fact that it's organic, that you can easily share anywhere and that they encourage it. And you can bring people from TikTok now back to, excuse me, Instagram back. I mean, there's, I'm going on and on, but there's a lot. It's refreshing.
Yeah.
You know, I Instagram has gotten really stale, and when they changed the algorithm, I think it was, you know, personally, I think it was a big mistake.
Yeah.
And, but that's, you know.
Exactly. No, I think there's a lot of meat that we can really break into different episodes and talk
about. I know, it's sorry,
about
I've been getting so into it lately, yeah. you know, that I'm like, it's hard for me to keep it short, but.
Yeah, well, let's talk about one more thing, and then we'll say goodbye for our friends for now. Okay. And of course, I will have you back in another time. So continue talking.
Definitely, there's a lot to talk about.
Yeah, then a lot of testing, but let's talk about maybe one of your best performing posts on TikTok. If you can describe it, I'm going to show it here on the side. What's one of your best, performing post on TikTok?
Okay, so there are two of them, but I would say that the first one that really went viral was my doing a reveal. Actually, not exactly a reveal of my oyster painting. Mm-hmm. What I did, and I think I know why it succeeded, is I showed the painting and kind of brought it closer to the viewer. Mm-hmm. And I had a call to action, which told them, check out the spoon. And I said clearly, I said, my client who hired me asked me to put the kitchen in the spoon. And people were like, what? And I made it fairly short, right? 8 seconds.
8 seconds.
8 seconds. So at a minimum, 8 seconds is a good number to go by. So 8 seconds, they looked at it. And what I did is that I, at the end, people wanted to rewatch it because they didn't quite see it, right? So I made the video so that they couldn't really exactly see it. So they had to see it again. And that's the key with TikTok, is that if you get repeat views, then it shoots up to the For You page.
So how many views did you have on that one?
It's a good question. I think I'm up to, is it 1 million? That one has 800,000 maybe.
Wow, almost 1 million views. That's incredible.
It really is. But I think that, I think there's that one. There may be another, but... But a million views. You could have never
get that on Instagram, right? Never. So no. Forget about Facebook. But now on TikTok, let's say a post like that, is it still fresh content? Even though you did it a while ago, people still watch it?
So I'll give you an example. If you make a post and within the first, let's say half an hour, well, first hour, you have at least 400 to like 1,000 views. Uh-huh. TikTok's going to reward that because they see, oh, they like that. Somebody's interested in it. So after a little while, not necessarily the same day or the second, you know, you will find that all of a sudden it goes back onto the For You page. And now TikTok is going to show it to people from 1,000 to 10,000 people.
Got it.
And as you progress, the more and more people like it, then you go into 10 to like 40, 50,000 and, you know, it can go all the way to 40, 50, 60 million, and that's it. And they constantly reward you by showing it to more people.
That's exciting. Super cool, Nadine. Well, thank you so much for sharing, you know, some of the things that you're doing right now. We'll come back for more. This was just a little taste. And for sure, you got me excited too. And I opened my account of TikTok like long time ago, probably before my kids, and I didn't do anything with it. I forgot about it. And then, just last week, I started posting every day, and so I'm taking it back seriously and having a fun time, you know, with the application and looking at everything that it can do. Thanks also for your help on that. So for our friends who are not following you right now on TikTok or who are now curious to see what you're doing, where can they find you in the platform?
Oh, cool. Yeah, they can find me at Nadine Robbins Artist. Nadine Robbins Art. Oh my God.
Art. Okay. Nadine Robbins Art. And you can find me on TikTok if you want to see also how I'm working on it as Sergio Gomez Art. So we'd love to see you there. Say hello as well. Let us know if you watch this episode and any takeaways that you had from it as well. So thank you, Nadine, for being here with us. We will have you back again very soon. Good. And showing more of the content and some of the things that you're doing. So thanks again, our friends. If you enjoyed this episode, please share it with all your friends, and we'll see you in TikTok. Goodbye.